Hello. In case you've not seen me before or you've forgotten who I am, my name is Jonny and I work for NISCU, that's the Northern Interschools Christian Union, which means I go into many schools, including LGGS. And today I'm here once again on a screen to share a Christmas thought with you. First, though, I thought I would ask you a few either or questions. So I'll give you some choices and maybe you'll find out a few things that you didn't know about the person sitting next to you. So first of all, would you choose a holiday in the snows of Scandinavia or the sunshine of the Caribbean? Which one would you go for? Let's say hands up for Scandinavia and hands up for the Caribbean. There you go. Second one. Would you choose to stay for a night in a hotel in a city or a tent in the countryside? Which would you prefer? Hands up for the hotel and hands up for the camping trip. Okay, finally, would you choose for your dessert on Christmas Day to have Christmas cake or chocolate Yule log? Hands up for those who prefer Christmas cake. And hands up those who would eat the chocolate Yule log. And hey, why not? Hands up for those who would definitely have both. Christmas is a time of choice. Choosing what gift to buy for a friend, that can be challenging. Choosing what food to indulge in, choosing who to spend your time with and where. Of course, in the story of the first Christmas, Mary and Joseph had a bit less choice. They didn't get to choose a pleasant holiday destination. They were ordered by the ruling authority, the Romans, to travel to Bethlehem. And when they got there, they did not get either a hotel or a tent. No one would let them stay inside because of the perceived indecency of Mary's pregnancy. And despite our traditional nativity scene, they probably didn't even have a cozy stable for a shelter either. Most likely they stayed out on some back street. And when Jesus was born, he was laid in an animal's feeding trough nearby. But the Christmas story is still a story of choice. For Christians, it's the time when God chose to come to earth to bring a renewed hope to people. And he didn't come in power, but he chose to come as a baby, weak and vulnerable. Scientists have proven that the universe had a beginning, and since nothing comes from nothing, presumably there must have been someone to begin it. For Christians, this is God. But God came to earth as a baby to show that even though he's powerful enough to create the universe out of nothing, he wants to meet us where we are, to come down to our level and even serve us. And God chose Mary, a young girl, probably a similar age to some of you, to carry and care for this baby. He didn't go to a palace or to the seat of world power at the time in Rome, but he chose someone who would truly care. And Mary didn't take this lightly. She would have been terrified by this prospect, but she responded with an open heart. The Bible says in the book of 1 Corinthians that God chose things the world considers foolish in order to shame those who think they are wise. And he chose things that are powerless to shame those who are powerful. At the time of Jesus' birth, women had little say or social influence in the world. And outside of the Bible, history records very few women from the time, especially young women. But the Bible tells us that God considers everyone important and worthy of note. Hence, here we are more than 2,000 years on, still talking about Mary. This Christmas, as you choose where to put your Christmas tree or which present to open first, take a moment to consider those who won't get a choice, whose lives are filled with struggle and challenge. And remember that for Christians, God chooses to love those people as much as he chooses to love us. Whether you think about refugees in distant places or someone on your street, someone in your class who you know is having a hard time, or even someone in your family, we have a choice to demonstrate love, to let them know that they have value and to bring them hope at this season. And I hope that you also know that whatever challenges you face, there is always hope. God bless you. Have a very happy Christmas.